that makes its way into the Bay of Quinte and on to Lake Ontario. We are in Eastern Ontario for this year's M&M Meat Shop's Canadian Junior Curling Championship. Canadian Women's Junior Championship comes down to this shot. A year ago, Trish Paulson of Saskatoon stole a win in the semis and then needed to do the same in the final. And when Calgary's Nadine Chiz rolled too far, another steal sealed the win for Saskatchewan. This is the launching point for future Scotties champions. This is the Canadian Junior Curling Championship on TSN. We are in Napanee, Ontario, midway between Belleville and Kingston, Ontario, the Strathcona Paper Centre, as this week-long championship comes to an end. It is championship weekend as we say hello, Canada, welcoming you inside. We'll have the women's final tonight. We'll have the men's final tomorrow, as this really does kick off our season of champions right through till the World Men's Championships from Switzerland in the middle of April. 13 men's teams, 13 women's teams from across the country began play last weekend. And in women's play, there were no tiebreakers. Manitoba, Alberta, BC through to the playoffs. Manitoba grabbing first place by virtue of their 9-5 round-robin win over Alberta, leaving Alberta to play BC in this afternoon's semifinal. And it was a two-point lead for BC and Kesa Van Osch from Nanaimo. But then, Red Deer Alberta's Jocelyn Peterman in the ninth has this shot. It is a beauty. The run back, double, and she would score four. There they are, one, two, three, and four, as she went on to the win. And now it is Alberta against Manitoba in the final, as Russ Howard snuggles up. We may be doing this. This is a cold building. Oh, yeah. It's a Strathcona Paper Centre. Look, we've been very impressed over the course of several years now about the play of junior teams. And really, it comes down to coaching. And when you talk about coaching, some of the best is in Manitoba.
Well, they've got a great high-performance program under the tutelage of Connie Laliberti, another great champion that played so well in Manitoba for years. But this young team here, from Manitoba, the strategy what's impressed me. They're not afraid of anything, but their stats are high, too. Three of them are number one. The other second is second position. They're going to be tough today.
Shannon Burchard, of course, from the St. Vital, well-known club in Winnipeg. Alberta, this is a no-quit team. Last year, they lost the Alberta Provincial Final to get to the Canadians. They also lost the final of the Canada Winter Games. They break through this year, and all during the week, they never gave up.
Well, another tough province to get out of. We know that in the men's division and the ladies. But 6-0 they were down, Vic, in the middle round-robin game to Newfoundland. Came back and won at an extra end. Team tenacity here. And as we saw that shot, Jocelyn made a beauty for four. That made the big difference in the semifinal.
So they were the two best teams all week. And appropriately, they're going to meet for the Canadian Women's Junior Championship here in Napanee. It is Manitoba against Alberta. When we come back here on Canada Sports Leader, TSN.
The M&M Meat Shop's Canadian Juniors is brought to you by M&M Meat Shop's. Hundreds of meal ideas, one aisle. The M&M Meat Shop's Canadian Juniors is brought to you by Capital One. What's in your wallet? By World Financial Group. Proud to be a sponsor of the Season of Champions. Your dreams, our strategies. And by Cashmere Bathroom Tissue. Nothing feels like cashmere.
Alberta and Manitoba, they're ready to take the ice in this women's final of the M&M Meat Shop's Canadian Juniors. Time to meet the teams now. It's brought to you by Ford, Drive One. The Alberta champions are from the Red Deer Curling Club and will be there next weekend, of course, for the Scotties Championship. Jocelyn Peterman is backed up by Christine Anderson, Rebecca Conchu, and Brittany Tran. The Manitoba champions come out of the St. Vital Curling Club in Winnipeg. But make a note, Shannon Burchard does skip the team, but she throws the third stone. It is Selena Cates that throws the fourth rock with Maria Mondor and Christine McCush, who's at second. Now, we mentioned, of course, that Manitoba was awarded first place after their round-robin win, 9-5. And because of that, they had the choice of hammer. They elected to take the last rock here in this opening end. And so to get us underway, playing the Red Stokes, the Alberta lead is Christine Anderson.
First thing we're going to notice here today, Beck, is the massive amount of curl from the hog line in. This rock is a foot and a half, 2 feet off the center line. Watch this thing turn. Just a great service for both teams. They also played in a curling club with the men's and women's division. There's so many teams that they split it up into two rinks, and there was a lot of curl over there also. And kudos to Jamie Sage and his team. They've got some rocks here, local rocks, but there's tremendous finish. And what you're going to notice that you might not see at a Scott or a Breyer is the amount of curl with a hit. The hits are even moving.
Well, let's take a look at what you think the game plan may be. It's brought to you by World Financial Group. Your dreams, our strategy.
Well, every Manitoba team I've ever played has been tough to beat, and I've never seen a Manitoba team that doesn't like an outturn. And the same thing here, 200 more outturns than interns for the week. The weird part for this is Alberta's have the same record, 10-2, but they really favor the interns. It's going to be interesting going around corner guards, center guards, which turns they're going to pick. Manitoba wants the outturn, Alberta wants the intern.
Okay, why? Why would Manitoba favor? I'm thinking my thought would be immediately tuck delivery back in the day, but why would it still be that way today?
Well, I think that's the way it starts. There's a couple tuckers out here, and it's just habits we get into. Sometimes you just call the lead rock an outturn because that's just what you do, and then you tend to play the whole end that way. And if you do that for your whole career, you get used to it. It's something. It's a comfort feeling. A safety blanket, if you will. And but normally, most curling teams, the average, I would say maybe 70% of the curling teams like outturns. So we always used to try to force a team to the intern, but that's exactly what Alberta's better at.
It's a wide open first end as the first rock went in. You suggested, you told me before we went on the air, you used to play Ed Wernick that way.
Oh, yeah, no kidding. He had the great Neil Harrison at lead, one of the best leads that ever played the game. And he virtually refused to play an intern. One funny story, we played Eddie in a spiel, and I had Neil on my team at the end of Eddie's career. And instead of throwing a center guard, Eddie threw one way over in the corner, forcing Neil to throw an intern. I called for the intern. Neil shook me off and went way out wide by the divider and played the out turn anyways, made it perfect. And you just get used to certain shots out there, and that's what's going to be interesting in this game.
This surprises me a little bit in some respects. I'm going to argue with myself. I did talk with Alberta coach Nancy McKinnery before the game, and I said, so how are you going to play that? She said, I think we're going to go right after them. Well, obviously, they want to get used to the ice first, and they haven't played.
But it looks close.
On TV with microphones, so you may as well get used to it.
And it's like Florida out here with those TV lights. It's bright, and that's the first thing you notice when you haven't played in a television game. And it can affect the ice a little bit. It can make it a little bit straighter, it can make it a little bit quicker. And it's not a bad move for Manitoba here. The Alberta played this afternoon with these conditions, with the lights on. Not a bad idea to go run it up and down for an end or so.
Well, that was one of the reasons when she said it to me, that, you know, we think we might go after them right in the first is because we've just come off the ice. There is Nancy.
See the amount of ice being taken for this intern hit. Now the rock is a little deep, so it's got more time to curl, but they're expecting about a foot of curl on a normal weight hit. That's a lot of curl.
Did a nice job to hold it on the stone from Brittany Tran. This Alberta team has been together for 3 years. You mentioned that last year they lost the Canada Games final, lost the provincial final to go to the championship in Calgary. 17-year-old Shannon Burchard throws the third stone, but skips for the Manitoba champions from Winnipeg.
We probably first saw that with the Furby Nettowin team when Randy, because of his lack of sweeping ability, skipped the game and had David throw the last two bricks. And obviously that was one of the most successful teams in the history of curling. And it's branched out and a lot of teams are experimenting with it. We did it with our Olympic team, and Brad Gush, who had to do all the sweeping, he said he liked it. He liked it a lot. It seemed to keep him calmer and relaxed, and all he had to worry about was making his last two shots. And,
takes out some of that nervous energy.
Yeah. And I think it's less complicated in a lot of ways.
High five. I didn't think it was that far up. Okay, you got it, Sam.
Mondor and McCush, nice crushing to hold it for Shannon Burchard. The Manitoba team, this is their first year together. And as Russ talked about, they are coming out of that high performance program set up by the Manitoba Curling Association and under the directorship of Connie Laliberte.
I had the chance to go to the Women's Provincials. My daughter played with Kathy Overton this year, and they had a good run at the Provincials, and I was really impressed with how they run the events and this high-performance camp. Connie was there all week, actually, and it's so important to have that with the youth, and that's the future of your sport, and that's one of the reasons Manitoba always does well.
Skip stones here in this opening end, up and down the sheet. Notice as the numbers came up, the percentages for Alberta and this team from Red Deer, none of their numbers really are outstanding. Nobody on the team made the all-star team, yet here they are in this championship game and tied for first place at 10-2.
Yeah, their numbers were lower, there's no question about it, 5% lower as a team compared to Manitoba, but Manitoba, of course, was number one, but it's not always... The amount you make, it's when you make them. And that wonderful shot that Jocelyn made for four, that was either, she was either going to win the game or lose the game in the semifinal, made a pistol.
So here is the first all-star fourth rock thrower. This is Selena Cates. She is 20 years of age. This is her final junior event. And now unable to hold it for her. And how aggressive do you try and be here with one rock to come if you're Alberta?
Yeah, I think he can have nothing to lose here, just to try to weld one onto that corner of that yellow one and create a bit of havoc for Manitoba. So you can see they're taking virtually 6 feet of ice here. That's a tremendous finish.
Or do you just want to go center?
Huh?
Or do you just want to go?
No,
center?
Like this.
I don't mind this.
Might as well, right?
Four.
Yeah. You got it.
If you want to right to it, or
if
seven?
You can, if you're just a seven, then.
Okay. Go four.
Yeah, zero risk here. Vic, just get it back there somewhere. Try to line it up. If you could freeze it on there, it'd be very difficult to remove.
Mine's pretty good.
Final stone for Jocelyn Peterman.
It's pretty good.
Not to it. Seven.
Wait for it.
Line's fine. Room. Chris.
Hey, line's good. To it.
Christine Anderson is on the right. Rebecca Conshu is on the left now, trying to drag it down and just glue it right on the corner if they can.
Yep.
Great try, real confidence builder through the exact perfect speed. Needed a hair less ice, but that's you can't miss it on the inside.
Nine.
Final stone here in one, facing one, Selena Cates, and again. McBush and Mondor forced to pick her up, trying to hold it now. Gets across the nose and will spin it far enough. So they'll take a look. From overhead, it looks like it is a blank as the stones are kicked away, and so Manitoba will hold the last rock. It is the women's final, the M&M Meat Shops Canadian Juniors. We are in Napanee, Ontario for the 2012 M&M Meat Shops Canadian Junior Championships. All the teams staying here for the championship weekend. Lots of family. They're staying here in Napanee. They're staying in Belleville. Teams are in Kingston as well. 13 men's, 13 women's teams. All 10 provinces, Northern Ontario, Yukon, and Northwest Territories fielding separate teams. And so that's why there is the 13, unlike the usual 12. We'll see, for example, when the Scotties begins a week from today in Red Deer, Alberta. Welcome back to Napanee. A blank in the first means that Manitoba continues to hold the hammer. They have the last rock here in this second, playing the Yellow Stones. And this is the Alberta lead, Christine Anderson.
Christine wanted to hang around there. Here's a first chance for Manitoba. They decide to hit, play defensively with the first one. Christine put it in such a good spot. I think Manitoba decided to hit it. But now there's a chance to either throw the corner or put one in the side of the sheet. Ideally, you want to throw a corner guard here, Vic, and try to get something going. It's a low-risk way to try to score your deuce.
Where? Wait, it's a bit of
Mariah Mondor is the only player on the ice who has previous national junior experience. A couple of years ago in Sorrell Tracy, she was the second for Breanne Meekin. That was the year that Rachel Holman won the juniors, and of course Rachel has gone on to some terrific, winning the Ontario championship and then lost the final of the Ontario's this year.
Yeah, tough loss. She ran the table, 10 straight victories, and just came up short in the last game. And it's a tough way to go out, but there's a team you're going to hear a lot from in the future. Big rotation on this, Vic. Maybe a little bit less curl with this rock than the rest of the teams.
You know, we mentioned that this is really the future of the game in our country. When you look at the likes of Rachel Holman and Caitlin Laws and Stacey Devereaux, who have gone on to have success in women's play. This is also a big weekend in provincial men's playdowns, and we'll be keeping you updated on some of the scores throughout the evening as they make their way. Tomorrow, Sunday, is the championship day for so many of the provinces, but several key games are happening this evening in places like Ontario and Manitoba and Alberta, where Jeff Stoughton and Kevin Martin are in must-win situations. So when we get some scores, we'll be sure to pass them along.
Yeah, it's no picnic getting out of those provinces, out of any province for that matter. And it's there's always upsets, and there's always some close games, and it's going to be an interesting weekend.
Wait's good. Line only.
Four. Five. Okay, that's fine, Beth.
Five. That's it. Nice roll, Beth.
Well, you don't see this very often in any form of play, but an eight was scored in the semifinal in Northern Ontario today. Brad Jacobs, the two-time defending Northern Ontario champion, scored eight in a 14-3 win over Tim Phillips. Tim Phillips is a former Northern Ontario champion, represented Northern Ontario in 2000, 2002. And so it will be Jacobs against Mike Jacobo for the Northern Ontario final tomorrow.
Unbelievable eight-ender. Like, that's the odds of getting an eight-ender are much tougher than getting a hole-in-one in golf, just to put that in perspective. So great use of last rock advantage there. Big eight-ender for Brad, that's going to be a heck of a final. Mike nearly won last year, so that should be a good final tomorrow.
Just a 10?
Whoa. Clean.
9.5.
Whoa.
9.5, 10. Wait, nice.
Clean. Once again,
just clean.
Wide open,
clean.
Checking
yep.
in.
Yep.
Alberta
yep.
third, Brittany yep. Tran.
Yep. Yeah, hard. Yep.
Nice shot, Britt.
Nice throw, Britt. Got a girl.
We tend to criticize this move a lot, but I think what happens, it's you know, again, the final, Manitoba has not played in front of the lights. It's just really bright in here. The ice is going to be a wee bit different. It's a gut feel for the skip, and if she doesn't feel like getting into a draw game and playing some finesse shots, they have the hammer. They can do whatever they want. They can dictate it. Now, I don't see this happening for three or four more ends, but that's what she wants to do right now.
Yellow if they sweep
boy,
it.
Look at this. Wonderful shot. Shannon Burchard. Just not quite. But I think this is the kind of thing that I know has impressed you, impressed Linda, is the shot making. And it's developed over the course of, I'd say, the last maybe 10 years or so. And I think for a couple of reasons. Give full credit to the Canadian Curling Association for the development of the game and the coaching.
Ooh, that might hang around.
And it will. So the jam at the back may force now Manitoba into taking a single. But the other thing is, over the course of time, with so much on television, juniors have been able to watch and learn the strategy from the best in the world on the ice. And you, for example, Linda, here in Telestream.
Well, exactly. I think, you know, I just go back, well, they got to hang around here. This could overcurl.
Big opportunity now, and again, great crushing. Mondor and McCush.
But you're right, Vic. I didn't feel like I was a world-class player until I was in my early 30s, and that was the reason. You can't fast-track like some of these players have because they now get the exposure to the top events, the top games. They can watch the Briars and the Scots and the Worlds and the Skins games and all the different strategy from the greatest players in the world, and that's the best way to learn. Curling's one of those games that you can be a good player, but there's a lot more to it than that. You have to do the ice reading, the strategy, how to miss. There's way more to be a world-class player, and they can pick that up just by watching television.
Skip Stones here in two with Manitoba. Sitting two. They also have the last rock. And very nice. Jocelyn Peterman getting Alberta out of an early jam.
Very nice is indeed. A lot of speed on that, Vic. Good leg drive, great balance. And as you mentioned, too, it's the form that impresses me. There's just no bad deliveries anymore. And it's not just the final two teams here. They all played well this week. I was really impressed with the BC team. They had an unfortunate break, really, in the ninth end, or they might have won the game and been here in the final.
You got it.
Not much of square shoulders, the broom in the right position. Balanced delivery, obviously. Doesn't kick out too hard. A little bit of an extension, lots of rotation. A lot of good things in that delivery.
Kristen McCush is on the right. Mariah Mondor on the left.
Seven. Yeah, a little.
Eight.
Right where they put the brush, isn't it?
Yeah, right on, dead on with the weight again.
97.
She asked her front end what they get, and what she's saying, she's asking for the split time. They said 97. That is a 397, 3.97 seconds. That's pretty fast. That's from the back line to the hog line, and it takes 4 seconds for the ruck to get all the way down the other end with that high a number. That's fast ice. Most curling clubs, to put that in perspective, would be around a 3.5 or a 3.6.
Nine and a half.
Whoa.
Whoa.
There is an outside chance to jam this if you hit it absolutely wrong.
No roll.
That's fine.
And she'll avoid the jam. Shooter will spill out the back, and so it'll be a free one for Selena Cates in Manitoba.
Wait, was good. Hey, if anything,
don't just run there and whip this out. You want to keep your form, and you want to find a spot in the ice you haven't seen in practice or in the first two ends. Use this to your advantage. Throw this down clean and try to read it afterwards and get a good feel for what that spot in the ice is going to do later.
She was the first All-Star throwing the fourth stone, Selena Cates. So we'll put another blank on the board here in the second. Manitoba will still hold the last rock when we come back to Napanee, Ontario. Oh boy, let's step into the time machine. Mr. Peabody, let's set it for 1991. Leduc, Alberta. New Brunswick, Heather Smith-Dacey. Playing Manitoba, skipped by Jill Thurston. Thurston had her chances to win, but problems with draw weight meant it would go to an extra end, and then that extra end, Heather Smith-Dacey looking on. Thurston's final stone was heavy, and Heather Smith-Dacey would win New Brunswick's first Canadian Junior Championship. Who will win this year's Canadian Women's Junior title? Alberta or Manitoba's? We welcome you back to Napanee, Ontario. Blanks in one and two as we pick up play here in the third, and Manitoba will once again have the last rock playing the Yellowstone. Center guard goes up from Alberta, and then the come around is heavy. This is the Alberta lead, Christine Anderson.
Five, six.
Yeah, Mariah would love that one back. It's the first chance to have an offensive opportunity for Manitoba. She whipped it through the rings. Had to be short there.
Line's good.
Well, you can see how the Canadian Junior Championship in this year's Scotty, seven skips. Heather Smith-Dacey will be there, representing, of course, Nova Scotia for the second year. Last year, finishing third, Amber Holland, Jennifer Jones, Kelly Scott, Heather Nedewin, Marie-France LaRouche, Andrea Kelly out of New Brunswick returns. It is going to be a terrific field, and the Scotties all starts next Saturday from Red Deer, Alberta.
Well, it really is, Vic. There's a lot of parity in that field. Some of the teams that are big names haven't played that well this year. Other ones that you maybe aren't household names are playing really well. And there's going to be a lot of upset games in that. I really think there's going to be a lot of people around that 7-4 area vying for that last playoff spot. To the form here, the chance for Alberta. They went around on the intern side, which is their shot. Manitoba countered with the out turn. It's going to be interesting as this game goes along. If you can force your opponent to that other turn, it could make all the difference here.
Nice throwback. Nice weight.
All three come arounds with beautiful speed, but all three have overcurled here. Let's keep an eye on this. There's a tremendous finish coming in. This rock gets by the guard by a ton of ice and still over curls.
Yeah. Even if you just go like that, that's okay.
Okay.
Probably throw enough weight to tap both of these reds back if you hit it dead on, or better still, get to the inside. It's all speed here.
Yes!
Kristen McCush. As we play second stones, they can hear Shannon Burchard calling on Mariah Mondor and Selena Cates right away. As it starts to bust now to that centerline guard, just get it by, they did. Nice brush, tap it back, move them back, sit for 1-2, top of the four.
Great rush, one end to the other, just sneaks it by that center guard, made all the difference in the world. Beautiful throw.
Down a bit.
You really have two teams here from what I've seen so far that are not worried. They are not uptight about the situation. They're in the Canadian final. It's the biggest game of their lives for both teams, and they're very relaxed. Lots of communication. Well-thrown rock there. Good speed control.
Rebecca Conchu throws the second stone for the Alberta champions that are red here.
Whoa. Nice shot back.
Nice throw.
And avoids the jam and squeezes it out the back.
That can't be right.
Three red in there, but it's still a great chance for Manitoba here. A little flop to the inside. Might catch that back red if they want, but the main thing here is try to hide this in behind the center guard.
Just 10.
She was the first team all-star at
second.
Kristen McCush.
Close.
This is real close. Real close to making it good.
Hard roll.
Oh, just not quite. Kristen's aunt is Jill Officer.
Really?
So she knows all about playing second.
There you go.
And, of course, we'll see Jill. Jennifer Jones.
Wait, it's good.
Manitoba champions. And in the Scotties, starting next week.
Off.
Oh, boy, a lot of speed on this one. A little inside-out motion. This could be going by everything.
Catch something.
Okay.
Just a little bit,
that's
and
fine.
Now it's hidden.
That
might have been a bit of nerves there, Vic. You tend to do it when you're looking at the double. You're trying to move 80 pounds of granite, and you tend to give it that little extra, and that's what caused it to run a little straighter.
Okay, you got it.
She'd love that one back.
Okay. 9-5?
Okay.
Interesting call here. You've got Alberta on the ropes. You've got Hammer. You've got two rocks in good positions here. Hitting this back one, it might end up on the scoreboard, but I'm protecting it won't. I don't think it will. I'd be tempted to go right around on the intern side, sink another one, and have three buried.
9-5.
Once again, good brush to hold it, and then she'll get to roll in behind. And it is Manitoba sitting three with last rock here in the third.
Very defensive approach. You're 10-2, and you've got Hammer in the final game. It can't be wrong. You can't criticize it, but nice chance for a double here and possibly roll buried.
Yep.
What, do you think you can get across the nose and tuck yourself underneath a little bit?
I think you can. There was a beautiful stone thrown two shots ago that got to the inside with at least half weight. So I think there is an inside motion here to get it partly buried. Probably more importantly, to get that back double. You can make anything in this ice. There's so much girl.
Just board.
Whoa.
This looks a little hot also.
Whoa.
Brittany Tran. Nothing yet. Got to come up for her.
No.
Going to catch it on the way by. No,
okay,
stuff
fine.
It. Manitoba's sitting a definite one. Maybe even a close two.
Yeah. Is there a roll in, or are we just...
We'll just roll, like, on top. Like, right here.
Okay, do you like that?
Yeah. Hack?
Yeah.
Okay, you got it.
You got it, Chan.
That's good.
Hack is
a little
like
80.
Less. It's like a 7-5-8.
Okay.
Love to get to the inside here. The easiest shot's just to hit half a rock, roll to the outside. But that exposes that one at the back of the forefoot. So if you'd ever get to the inside here, you'll in behind that center guard.
Again, they're going to flirt with this center guard.
Keep going hard, open it up.
And this time they can't save
it. That's fine. Oh, wait.
Oh, sorry.
That curl was huge. Wasn't even close to getting by the guard. Chance for Alberta to get out of this in.
What is run?
8.5.
Okay, you got her.
Probably. Well, a little effort.
8.5, a little more weight than her normal weight, a little bit up normal.
Okay, you got her.
Again, watch the form here. I like the shoulder position, dead straight. A lot of people get the throwing shoulder lower, which causes a lot of overextensions.
Jocelyn Peterman, and then her first. Got Alberta out of a jam in the second, made a nice double. And they'll do it again. Boy, how this has turned around from Manitoba sitting three. Look at the house now.
What a difference, and two dangerous ones in front of the tee line. Nice throw there. Now, this the only good news for Manitoba is there's just about a perfect triple here. I think you can actually come down here, do that over to there, and on it, almost a natural. If you get hit it maybe a little bit less than half, they could all fly here.
Cates, give it a little push.
And it was an outward push. This has to curl. There it goes.
McCush, Mondor, one, two, got them all. A little bit more, a little bit more, a little more. No, it'll hang around and spin back and sit.
Great try. I actually had to sweep it a hair more. That really curling. I don't think I've seen in a long, long time the hits move as much as they are in this surface here. These rocks are so aggressive. That looked wide halfway down, and it actually overcurled a hair. She would have got all three of them. Nice throw.
Just 9.5. 10.
Yeah.
This curls in this spot. Oh, big time.
Gotta hang around here. You want to force if you can if you're... Alberta.
Clean.
Just had enough speed there. I thought it was going to be a little late for a while. Come across that center line. Good throw.
And so Manitoba will face the two.
Just down there.
Yeah. Nice throw, though. Yeah.
Awkward spot, though, Russ. I mean, she's right on the center line. I think halfway in the 8 foot. I guess you can bang this right on the nose and still get shot.
Still be shot, yeah. And if you happen to cross it, you might get lucky going over to that other red. But pretty routine shot. They played a couple in this spot earlier. And with the option of in turn or out turn, Manitoba goes out turn.
Yeah.
Consistent with the scouting report.
Linda didn't call you with that.
That's right.
You did this on your own. She rolls it in to cover the edge of the 8 foot. We have our first point. It comes here in the third. Manitoba's on the board and they have the lead. Shannon Burchard out of the St. Vital Curling Club in Winnipeg trying to become the latest in the long line of Manitoba Junior Women's Champions. 1995, Regina, Kelly McKenzie, who we now know as Kelly Scott, playing Ontario's Kirsten Harmark, and it was really steals all the way. Harmark wrecks on her guard, and Scott would steal a point in four straight ends. She gave up one in the ninth, but it really didn't matter by that point, as Kelly Scott would go on to a 5-2 win, and win for Manitoba, the 1995 Canadian Junior Championship. Look at some of the great curlers from Manitoba who have won, from Pizarro back in the 70s to Karen Fallis, Kathy Orvin Clapton, Jennifer Jones, Kelly Scott, and Caitlin Laws, of course, who now plays with Jennifer Jones. And Shannon Burchard with the early lead here, scoring one in the third as we welcome you back to Strathcona Paper Center on this championship weekend with the M&M Meat Shops Canadian Juniors. The women's final, and for the first time in the game, Alberta playing the Red Stones will have the last rock. So in goes the first stone, back 8 foot, up goes the corner, and now second rock played by Manitoba, top 12.
10-14.
Yeah. We talked about the contrast with Manitoba throwing out turns and Alberta in turns. There's a contrast in the strategy here already. Manitoba's been incredibly defensive. They could have frozen last end early. They could have drawn early. Could have thrown up some corner guards in the first two ends. Same situation here. Manitoba, two rocks and rings. Alberta's ignoring it. They're going to be the aggressor and see if it pays off. They're going to use that corner guard. That's what they threw it for. Go around it immediately and put some pressure on this Manitoba team.
Conchu and Tran with the brush. Big drag for them. And they will just get it to bite the top edge of the 12.
That died. Yeah.
Saying that one died a little bit.
Sorry, Chris, that was a great throw.
Might be getting a little sticky there. Good spot for that one, though, Vic. Like, everybody tries to get it buried, and by doing that, they tend to throw it deep, get it behind the tee line. Yes, it's buried, but it's an advantage for the opponent. Keeping it up that high, that's not easy to take that out of there, and they can use it later.
Into that rock.
No.
So isn't it interesting? Both second stones were the last one by Anderson, now the first by McCush.
Take the roll, Britt. Yep. You got her.
Looked a little light out of her hand, but I'll have to keep an eye on it. It could be slowing down there a little bit. You run out of pebble as the game goes along, but only in the fourth end that she can be a problem. Love to roll buried here behind all that pile on the left hand side.
They're overlapped.
Yep.
There's a hit.
Go,
there's a roll. Tran trying to pick it up. Oh, it is a beauty.
Just a great throw. Rolls it in the perfect spot. And the aggressive play has paid off here. Yes, they didn't get it buried around the corner guard the first time, but it forced Manitoba to play a draw, which they hadn't thrown many of. And now they have a great chance to score two or three points here, Alberta. Manitoba could hit that top yellow that came up light and peel out one red and open up the shot rock, but they've elected to play the freeze here. It's an aggressive call without hammer.
Yes!
Now they'll try and take it all the way back and bury it that way, and it will sit just for shot stone. It is covered, but it's behind the tee line, back edge of the four.
Smart call by Shannon there. It was going to wreck on the shot rock and bounce out in the open. And this way, it's at least it's partially buried.
Eight.
So from seven, nice seven, hit and roll eight, by Rebecca Conju now eight. Trying to draw down.
You're fine.
This is the key shot in the end. If they can lock it on this yellow one, there's a chance to score a big end this year. Has to finish.
Yeah. Go, Chris. Go. Okay. Thanks.
Spills out into the open, sits for shot stone. But that yellow junk at the back could be a bit of a problem.
Yeah, it could be, Vic. It really could. You know, that's obviously hitting a quarter of it would jam it. That'd be big trouble here. So you have to be very careful where this rolls. Also, even if you hit it dead on, it could set up a double or a triple. So she'd love, in the perfect world, to hit this red through the hole, the yellow hole, roll a little bit buried here.
Whoa!
Big weight.
No, don't touch
come right behind the sheet here, Vic, and with that much weight, it rarely bends enough to get to the nose. This could be trouble.
She really had to pull her hand off the handle before the hog line, and there you go. There's that little bit of a catches the corner, jams it, spills everything now of Manitoba to the back 12. And for the moment, Alberta here in the third is sitting two with the last rock.
Kudos to Alberta here, Vic. They've done, if you're a young team and you want to get to this level, you have to apply the pressure. You're not going to beat a team like Manitoba unless you apply pressure. That's exactly what Alberta has done. They've forced Manitoba to play tougher shots. If they can sneak another one in here somewhere, even in this area there, they can deal with these yellow rocks later. This rock here and this rock here are basically wide open. Protect what you have here now. The two reds can be taken away with a nice freeze. So top 12, top 8 foot, block that freeze at the back of the four.
Yeah. Where are you?
Where?
Like to that red one. Maybe a bit less. Pretty much to it though. A bit less.
Whoa. No.
Whoa. Yeah.
Oh, boy.
Okay, that's not bad.
So that little rub and the shooter will spill off to the back four, sitting three.
Kind of lost the communication there. The front end for Alberta said it was a little deep, but they didn't say where, and they just watched it crash on that shot rock and bounce out in the open. 70, that could hurt. 80.
With half, just nose?
Yeah, do you like that?
Yeah.
Okay.
If you wait with that, the extension was good.
Nice clean release, good rotation.
We're more than the last one.
More?
Yeah.
Girl.
Okay.
Mondor and McCush now just walking this one down.
Okay.
We'll push one through, but it is still now and totally covered. Alberta sitting two.
Great form, great delivery, up in the toe a little bit, but this is a situation with too fast a surface. Her back foot is very, very slippery. It's what they call a dip toe. She got to the hog line so fast, Vic, on both her throws. It was like a hot potato when she let that go. You obviously have to let the rock go clearly before the hog line. With that much speed on your slider, it causes problems on these great surfaces. And that was just a plain overthrow both times, and now they're in big trouble.
And Brittany Tran, you could hear her almost as soon as she let it go. Come on, come on, come on. She felt that maybe she was a little light, maybe a little inside.
Get it tight.
Alberta is sitting two buried here with last rock on the four.
That's not bad, Britt. That's about 31.
Still a chance out here for Manitoba?
Oh, for sure. This lock went in here in the forefoot. It's all about that last rock. The red one out in front actually helps Manitoba here to sink one. Just get it partly buried on the button somewhere, and the back red could cause problems for Alberta.
You got it.
Five.
Yep. Mine's good.
It's pretty good.
Selena Cates gathers herself. Five. This is her first as we play. Fourth stones. Boy, they've already worked plenty. McCush in Mondor. And again, the swing in this ice. Mondor actually going over. She was leaning so hard on the brush.
That's been the toughest part for the teams here, and you certainly can't blame anybody. It's just phenomenal ice. It's maybe too good. There's so much curl, and I was a little surprised Selena took edge of the eight there, because that's only 5 feet of ice.
Yeah, and if you end up putting in the hole, that's fine.
They've been getting 6 feet of ice virtually every single game, and they only took five for that shot. Speed wasn't bad.
So I like going like a five.
Okay,
yeah,
so throw.
I'm getting buried. If like a three, it's four isn't bad. Terrible.
Okay.
Calling for
throw
a five. A five
four
is right
five.
In this area here.
Yeah, somewhere in there.
Yeah, okay.
Be perfect to get it partially undercover here to stop that opening. There's not much Manitoba can do if you can get that in the right spot. Short's better than long. Not a big opening here between the two yellow guards. There's so much finish. This isn't really as big a hole as it looks on television.
Gotta wait for it.
Line's good. Line's good.
Yep.
But you almost have to, as you say, believe that it's going to curl.
Yeah, exactly, because right now it's on the center of that yellow corner guard.
Right. And now it starts to bust. So good judgment from Christine Anderson, Rebecca Conchu. To the top of the eighth. And Alberta with the last rock. They have the hammer. They're sitting three.
What a great shot. Jocelyn, since the ninth end of this afternoon semifinal, has made everything. That shot for four was a real boost for her, I believe, because that was right on the X. That's exactly where we put the rock in the telestrator. A little bit more difficult for her than it was for me. Great stone.
And you know what's interesting, as you look at this, look at that yellow-red combination out front.
Yep.
If you go back to what you said, rather than play the come around, if they would have opened up the shot rock at the time, which is the one in the in the 8 foot just outside the blue, outside the 4 foot, if you would have done that, it would have turned it around, right?
You're absolutely right, Vic. That's exactly the thought process when you're a top skip. And these are the type of ends you show back in a curling clinic or a strategy clinic. If that yellow raise, which was a gimme, was made, it would have opened the shot rock up and none of this would have happened. You're absolutely right. Huge shot here. It's got tremendous amount of ice here. If this is heavy, it will not curl.
Final stone, Manitoba, Selena Cates.
Curl.
The line's good if it's light enough. If it's not light enough, it won't finish.
Now they got to get by there. No, it'll crash. Now trying to spill it in, trying to cut them down if they can. Oh, and I don't know. It may have gotten there to cut them down to two for the moment. But did it pop out the other side?
That's close.
You know, they can make a play on it for a possible four,
right? It's wide open anyway, so the shot's there for four if they have to. Might be easier than coming through that hole with a draw anyways. Wow. And you're absolutely right, Vic. That's how it started, by not cleaning that front off. They left it there. Decided to freeze without hammer the next shot. And it's been all downhill ever since.
You got it, Joss.
Needs to roll here. Dead arm won't do it. Have to roll a little bit.
Need to roll towards the center line. Grab more of the 8 foot. Jocelyn Peterman, final stone. Has a chance for four. A little bit. Roll it inside, and there they are. Count them up. One, two, three, four for Alberta here in the fourth. They have been the comeback team all week, Alberta. Now they're going to try to hold on to the lead. Year-old Rebecca Conchu throws the second stones for the Alberta champions out of the Red Deer Curling Club. Not often a second presents a key shot, brought to you by Tim Hortons.
But that's exactly what happened. This is a key shot. We talked about Manitoba leaving the yellow rock, the yellow-red freeze, chance to open it up and get to the shot rock. They left it alone, and Rebecca made them pay. Didn't overthrow the shot, threw it to the brushers, rolls it right behind the yellow-red, and that's what set up the whole four-ender.
The key shot is brought to you by Scotty's Facial Tissue. Stylish designs for any room. So it's four for Alberta in the fourth. They lead it 4-1. Manitoba playing the Yellowstones will have the last rock. They have the hammer in five.
That's how fast it can turn around, Vic, isn't it? Manitoba an end and a half ago had a chance to sit three with hammer. They end up being 4-1 with one wreck in the guard, 4-1. Alberta played a very, very aggressive end and were rewarded with a big four.
But right after that shot of Conchu, if they go after those two stones overlap at the top, split them off, that shot's open.
Well, you not only would run your yellow-red and open it up, but you'd probably run the yellow into the rings. But like you said in the commercial break, that opens up the shot rock, and Virtue would have played the end out. The most Alberta would ever score is two. And if they happen to go on to win this game, Manitoba, I think, would like to look at that strategy mistake. Lots of time yet, though. With this much curl, you can make a lot happen. It's up to Manitoba to be as aggressive as Alberta has been. It's all about applying some pressure here.
Interesting. I know they're going the other way now.
So far,
they're having troubles.
Yeah. 4-4-5 somewhere in there. Make a good guess.
Yeah, the Manitoba draw weight's just been a little off. The one that came up light caused all the problems last end, and this is in a bad position also. And Alberta's going to try to hoop another one around and create some all kinds of pressure for Manitoba. Big, big finish in this spot. You have to take 6 feet of ice just to get by the guard. This is sunk, dead, buried if it gets by.
Well, Anderson and Tran are going to try to drag it around. Yes, they do. Oh, oh, goodness. Did you see Burchard out? She thought it was going to clunk, and she was going to be there to take her own stone.
Great sweep.
You wouldn't want your fingers between these two. Look out. Oh. It over-curled by a full rock.
Nice throw, though. Great sweep. Beauty. Great sweep. Really cuts at the end there, hey?
Yeah.
Like hard.
It's all about the yelling, Vixie. That's what got it by, that yelling.
Yes. Yeah. I'm surprised then all of your draws didn't.
Whoa.
What happened to yours when they crashed?
Some of the rocks are deaf.
Yeah. 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 Stone deaf, obviously.
I think I moved it. I touched it. I don't know if I moved it or not.
Okay, so
great try, awfully bad result. Not only did it not get the back rock when he missed it by a fraction, but now there's a stagger situation that's tough to raise either of those rocks, and a great opportunity for Alberta to apply some more pressure.
You're going right in, or would you just take it to bite the rings and overlap again?
I like just biting the rings here. Don't want to get too deep and set up a multiple peel here. And just stealing one here would be massive. Just get this top 12, even a foot short's fine. Idea is to tuck enough of it that you can't run it back.
Wait if you can. Whoa. Four.
Whoa. They got more room this time. They might have to brush it at the end to get it buried.
Chris.
Stay with it.
Chris, you got to go. You got to go.
Very, very nice shot.
It peaks just a corner.
Good awareness. You can see how well coached these teams are, Vic. That was a little bit deeper than they wanted, but they swept it just to get that a maximum curl. And now it's tough to run that straight back. It's impossible to run it straight back.
60?
Yeah. Nancy McKinnery has been coaching for 28 years. As long as they got that magnetic board in front of her, and that's moving the little magnets around. Uh-oh. Kristen McCush right out of her hand. Mondor and Cates. Mondor, Cates. No. Now, what they did, though, is get rid of that overlap. And so now that's a clean run back if Manitoba needs it.
Heard the front end say that was a slow rotating rock, and that's all it takes at this level. I mentioned at the top of the show that it's probably the most curl I've seen in years for the hits. Yes, the draws are going big also, but those are a little easier to control. But the hits are curling a lot more than most of these teams are used to, and a little soft rotation with the handle will accentuate that curl. And just lost another one on the inside.
Line's good.
Getting pretty messy here late in the end.
Three.
Over curling. Whoa.
Off. Nice shot, Britt.
Atta girl.
Just another perfect shot. Just staggered enough that it's hard to run it back in front of the tee line. Perfect draw weight out of Alberta so far.
Now, if you do run this yellow back, I mean, is there a chance that you can... I hate to think of the weight you have to throw, but you can get some things moving here.
Yeah, you can get two or three out of the way here. More importantly, get the top two and get a chance to get in that forefoot. This is a bit of survival here right now, Vic. I think Alberta's smelling an opportunity. There's no better chance than to go after a team when you've just scored four, because A, Manitoba's still reeling, and B, they're going to try to be a little aggressive, and they have to make sure they score here.
Well, I mean, this is the perfect opportunity. You've scored four. Don't let the guard down.
Yeah.
Keep the pressure on, right?
And you see a lot of teams do let the guard down.
Well, you see it in how many times do we say in hockey? You score a goal, and then you just let up, and the other team pots one.
Exactly. Whoop. Snuck another one in there.
And you know the other thing is, too, look at the yellow, the way it is right now. Look at that yellow stone out there. If there was a draw to be made to the button, that yellow stone comes into play.
Yes, certainly does. With that much finish, that is actually in way of the button. It's it needed to be over a little bit farther, that corner guard. And those are the little things that you forget about when you play the games like this. You come back and say, oh, if my skip hadn't wrecked on the guard, well, the guard shouldn't have been there in the first place. It had to be a little wider.
Brittany Tran.
On that one.
Whoa.
Five.
Whoa.
Six. Five. Four.
A little bit, Chris.
No,
if you can.
No.
Three, if you can.
Three.
Chris, yep.
Three.
Whoa. Little bit.
Yeah, go.
Okay, that's
nice
fine.
Shot.
Nice shot, Chris.
Brittany. Nice shot, Chris.
They're making everything. But they got to get some rocks moving here, Manitoba.
That's fine.
It's
okay.
I was trying to throw 430.
And I don't care whether it's juniors or women's play, men's play, or club play. The tendency here is to want to move everything and maybe overthrow it.
That's what exactly happened with the previous shot from Manitoba, that same outturn. That's twice it's actually happened here to Shannon. She just shoved it a little bit too hard and missed it wide. Now she's going on the intern side.
One, two, oh, and she just drives by the one at the back. So it is still Alberta sitting four without last rock here in the fifth.
Shannon need to hit that on the other side. Threw it very hard, but like you said, Vic, that'll throw you off. A little bit tight on the broom there, and had to hit that on the other side. It would have rattled a couple more reds out of there and had a chance. Very, very tough for Manitoba to score here.
Are you being a three or are you being a two?
Covering a piece of yellow, so I'd like being a three, but like behind it, kind of. Okay.
You got her.
Classic example, getting rocks in the right spots, and everything's in front of the tee line here.
Just a two.
Good.
Three.
Where is
two,
it?
Three.
I'm going to tell you what, they're... Both
three,
teams are getting to that hog line pretty quickly.
Oh, yeah.
The
arena ice is such a hard surface, and it's better underfoot. You get to the hog line quicker, and it's very, very important to have a footwear that isn't too quick.
No.
Oh. Think of Fat Ryan.
Ryan Express, yeah.
Oh. The man.
Definitely
the red. Feel?
Yeah. Okay.
Okay, feel.
You got it.
Like just off.
Elected to run the red one. It's not wrong. That's the one that's causing the most problems, but I don't think she can get too many rocks out of here with this one. She might only be able to remove one red. You could run the yellow corner guard in, take out a couple of red, maybe sit second or third shot and limit the damage here.
Selena Cates.
Yeah.
Whoa. Manitoba is big trouble here in five. Mondor, McCush, run it back. And stuffed it.
Oh.
And gets rid of one. And now leaves their stone out in front. But now...
You couldn't dream up a worse situation in curling. I've never seen anything like this. Great positioning by the Alberta team. A couple runbacks on the wrong side. One that hit and staggered. Big trouble.
And I think you make a good point. Alberta has played this so well. Every one of their stones has been in great position.
They really have, Vic. And there's really nothing here. Unless you ran this one down here and managed to get all four of them. Or if you actually try to run this one in, you're only going to get maybe one. You'll probably get, if you're running this rock here, you're probably giving up a steal of three. The only rock I see her using is this one here, and that is not a gimme. A well-positioned guard here, and you could be looking at the Canadian champion.
Three. Line's good.
Wait up a bit, Britt.
Four.
Four, five.
Oh, just
four.
Three.
Four, five. Coming four. Down.
Three. No line either.
Four. Three. Four,
you got to believe the line's three, fine. Four, five, there's nothing wrong with the line at all. They think it's wide, but it will finish. Be tempted to bring it a little deeper, stop that yellow raise.
That's okay.
Okay.
No, Chris.
To sit five without last rock.
Sorry.
That's right. Yikes.
Nice, sir. Well, I mean...
What do you do now in your Manitoba?
You got it. Wait. Back. It's like just off, eh? Back 12, yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Boy, in the perfect world, you could have brought that red one a little bit deeper into that area, and that would stop this shot right here, but it's still a one in a million. This is a very, very tough curling shot. It not only has to have exactly the right line, but it has to have the exact perfect speed, or you're going to give up a minimum of three, possibly five.
I like 85.
Okay, got it. So back 12 weight was the call.
Wait, 85.
Yep.
Just off the nose.
And for Selena, her draw weight's been great all week. It wouldn't be 10 and 2, but getting the right line in this raise is so difficult.
So facing five, an angle raise to catch the 4 foot. Oh, goodness. Mondor, McCush, they're trying to hold it for her now. Got to hold it for her. Got to keep it on that side of center line. It's going to over curl and crash in front. Now spill it in. Try to cut them down for something. Cut them down. And it'll spin back and have a look. And they will not. One, two, three, four. Five stolen points here in the fifth for Alberta. They'll go to the break, and Alberta is in control.
The M&M Meat Shop's Canadian Juniors is brought to you by Tim Hortons new lattes made with premium espresso.
Alberta's Jocelyn Peterman and her team from Red Deer have to be feeling pretty good. They're up 9-1, scored four with the last rock, steal five in five to lead Manitoba. Will this be a sweep of a championship weekend for Alberta? Brendan Butcher from the Saville Sports Center in Edmonton finished with a record of 11-1. He's into the men's final, and he will play either Brendan Wark of Thunder Bay or Manitoba's Kyle Deering of Winnipeg. They'll play the semifinal tomorrow afternoon. The winner will play. Butcher will have it for you. The men's junior final here on TSN Sunday evening at 7 p.m. Eastern Time.
This is a sheer advantage. So when you do get your rocks in the house, you know, she's going to be trying to double now, of course, more than anything, but that's okay.
Coach Lance Wedelius.
With some
positive thoughts, chip away. Manitoba will have the last rock in six when we come back to Napanee, Ontario.
The M&M Meat Shop's Canadian Juniors is brought to you by Scotty's Facial Tissue. Stylish designs for any room. By Capital One. What's in your wallet? And by Ford, official automotive partner of the Canadian Curling Association.
This Saturday night, we welcome you back to Napanee, Ontario, the 2012 M&M Meat Shops Canadian Juniors. My goodness, bad enough for Manitoba that Alberta got four in the fourth, but then to give up the steal of five in five. And so as we welcome you back, play just underway here in six, and it is Alberta with a 9-1 lead and a first stone from the Alberta lead. Christine Anderson goes just top of the button.
Two, three.
Manitoba lead, Mariah Mondor.
Gotta move.
Two.
Gotta move. Close. Yeah, go now. Yep. Yep.
So, Rush, you look for anything positive. And you
keep going, take it over.
You say, okay, there's five down, five to go. And you start to chip away. You've got to now play your game. You almost, it's almost unfortunate because if you're Manitoba, you almost have to play against instinct, don't you?
Yeah, very good point. It's so difficult to you want to get 4 points right back, and that is highly unlikely. So you get your two, maybe an outside chance for three, steal one and seven, and all of a sudden the Alberta team's like, well, now we're only six up, now we're only five up, now we're only four up, and you can sometimes I've been in this situation quite a few times, and you feel like it's slipping away and start overthrowing a little bit. Manitoba, let's face it, it's going to have to hope for a few mistakes. That's the only way they're going to get back in the game. But with this much curl, a lot of things can happen.
Okay, you got it.
Let's check the numbers after five, and they're brought to you by Tim Hortons.
Well, full marks Alberta, no question about it. What I liked about it was the aggressive play in the third end. When they had the chance, forcing two, they finally had hammer in three. They got Manitoba to go around the corner guards without hammer, and that's the kiss of death in the sport. It paid off with a beautiful hit and roll. Big four, went right after them the next end, and now they're up eight.
Tim Hortons, it's time for Tim's.
Can I go over a little more, Kristen Kerr? Yep, yep. Go! Yep, hard, even hard. Keep going hard. Hard. Yep, you got it.
Selena's percentage would be quite low if they're in the skip stones for Manitoba, but she's had some awfully tough shots. A very tough angle tap last end, another tough come around through a small hole in the fourth end for the four-ender. Really high degree of difficulty shot. And that's how you win games.
Go, Chris! Chris! Go! Go! Go, Chris! Go! Go! Go!
Very nice.
Rebecca is studying sport and recreation business at Mount Royal University.
I truly believe there's quite an advantage for Alberta to play this afternoon with 20. The TV lights on. I heard them in the break talking about how much quicker it is than it was yesterday, and I think it's fooled Manitoba a little bit.
Kristen works for IDC Communications. Alberta team being the comeback team of the tournament, and Russ made mention of the fact that they were down to Newfoundland and Labrador by six and then came back to win it in an extra. They battled back in the win over BC. Now we'll see how they handle the lead, and
nice throw back.
Certainly it is easier for you to do that, but sometimes teams don't handle leads well.
Well, you tend to overthrow. You tend to overthink. Do you stay aggressive? That's what got you the big lead, which could be suicide when you have a big lead, and you start trying to hit everything in sight, and it really can change your thought process. And it's something teams have to work on mentally during the season and say, look, we are eight up. What are we going to do? How are we going to play this?
No rotation.
No
handle. Whoa. Line's fine.
Just two, three.
Even guys.
Interesting. No rotation was the word from the brushers, or very little. I wonder, too, sometimes, it's about the mental part of the game. Because you're so concerned, you let the scoreboard get into your head, you forget your mechanics.
Oh, absolutely. No question about it. Absolutely, and you start looking. When you're winning, you start looking for things to go wrong. We got the six-ender against Finland at the Olympic final, and after the 2 minutes of euphoria, almost panic sets in because it's yours to lose. And some players can handle that, some can't.
So they've put up the corners. That hasn't worked. Now do you come in and maybe try to tap things back or freeze and play the game in the house?
Yeah, the red one's in a pretty good spot for the Alberta team. So you might freeze to this, use it to your advantage, to get to the inside, get around that corner guard. It's too late in the end to throw another corner. You're probably not going to score three, so try to get one buried here and get your deuce.
Just a little less.
Nice rotation.
Well, coach team, the front end giving a reminder to the thrower to keep the rotation up. That's exactly what went wrong with the previous throw.
Whoa.
Lack of rotation just turns sideways. I'm going to keep a bit of an angle on this. Keep it a little on the center line side, just slightly. This looks real good. Was gold if they kept brushing it. Just a slight error, and there's enough space to get this out of here.
Yep.
A little narrow here. Hit two-thirds of this, it's going to jam for sure.
But it squirts it in behind the guard, and now Manitoba might be setting themselves up for two. Okay, so who will be top dog? The Westminster Kennel Club Dog Show. The canine sporting event of the season will be live beginning Monday at 8 Eastern Time only on Animal Planet.
That was an awfully big fire hydrant for that dog show. Vic, is there a reason for that?
Enough said.
Okay.
Yeah!
It's always fun, though. I love Westminster.
Questionable call there, too, Vic. A little on the defensive side again, and it's easy for me up here, and I'm not the one that's down 8 points, but you threw that corner guard for a reason. You got one half buried, three quarters buried. Go around again. Created a little tougher shot for Alberta. This is a wide open hit for Alberta. They're not going to miss these.
We always bring it up. You against John Morris. Right?
Exactly.
I mean, listen, the guard was over more, but you stuck three behind it.
Yep.
You know, they miss, and you end up, get three or four.
Four. We got four. Lucky enough to get four.
That's your point. Yeah. If it crash, now you can split it.
Yeah.
Do anything you want. And now you're looking at a possible three.
Yeah. We'll be here till August before the Alberta team misses this shot.
Whoa.
Ooh, even better.
Spins a little too far. Shot stones still belongs to Manitoba.
Yeah, it actually rolled to a bad spot for Alberta. Good try. You wanted to roll to the center line there and then force Manitoba to hit it, and then there might be a double, but good throw just the same. Yeah, it's a numbers game. You need some points. You had the corner guard. If Manitoba gone around with the previous shot, there'd be two buried rocks, and you wreck on the guard, get your three, and you're right back in this thing. Now it's going to be a little difficult to get three. Selena's going to play a soft tap here, tap the yellow at the top of the four, frozen. Hopefully hide as much as she can of the shooter here and create a miss with Jocelyn's last throw. Quite a bit of ice here if you're going to tap it. That extra 3 feet of speed will stop this from curling.
Selena is at the University of Manitoba. We told you we would update some men's provincial tankards, and we could tell you that Brad Gushue, the gold medal winner from Torino, will qualify. He will represent Newfoundland and Labrador. He needed to be beaten twice by Ken Pettigrew. He won earlier today, 9-3. So congratulations to Brad Gujew. And we will see him in Saskatoon at the Tim Hortons Briar.
Well, nice to see Brad back there. He's no question the best team in the province. Ken Pettigrew gave him a good run in the round robin game, but would have had to beat Brad twice today and tomorrow. So off to the Briar one more time for Bradley. And they'll be tough, no question about it.
No, I don't mind.
So that's five teams that have now qualified. Some important playdown games going on tonight across the country. We'll update you when we get scores.
Do you like this?
Where are we trying to place?
Great awareness by Jocelyn. She'd kind of like to get into this area and, you know, ideally steal a point or something. But if that rock ends up in the wrong spot, if it ends up something later, which is only a foot deep, there'll be a double for 3 points. And that's the last thing you want to do with an 8-point lead. Even light here, Vicky, you kind of guard the draw. Yes, you're going to give up a single, maybe two. But you can make that shot for two for Manitoba a lot tougher by just going top 8 foot here.
She has to be at least third shot, does she?
Yes. There's an outside chance to play an intern tap. They'd love to get that in there. This is over curling.
Anderson and Konshu.
Two, three.
Now trying to take away maybe the double raise to get three. And that's what they've done.
Nice throw, Jess.
I mean, is there a way of coming with the intern to possibly get three and get that red stone?
I think there is, Vic. It's dead buried from the hack, maybe overburied, but that guard, the guard out here is a long way out. So you could, with perfect weight, tap that back. You only have to get it out of the full 8 foot, so there'd be a chance for three, but it's a low percentage shot. You miss it, you only get one, and one doesn't count at this point in time. So they're going to discretion the better part of valor here and go for the easier deuce.
So bite the blue.
Clean all the way.
Yep. 4 foot or two. Selena Cates.
It's a piece of four.
Eight.
Piece of four.
Well, just seven then.
Line's
well,
good. Piece
eight.
Of four.
First thought from the front end. Krista McCush was weight
Line's
was up.
Good. It's all you guys. All you.
Where?
Whoa.
Needs to come down. Whoa, don't touch it.
Needs four.
Six.
Needs to come down.
Good.
And it'll come down on the button. Quick look. It is two for Manitoba. You bet. Yes, that will be the next stop in the season of champions beginning next week in Red Deer, Alberta. And yes, Amber Holland will wear the maple leaf as Team Canada against a strong field of some familiar names. Heather Nedewin is back as Alberta champion. Kelly Scott, Jennifer Jones out of Manitoba. Newfoundland and Labrador's Heather Strong. Heather Smith-Dacey. Tracy Horgan, who was a winner in Ontario over Rachel Holman. Kim Dolan is PEI's champion for a ninth time. Marie-France Louche out of Quebec has a new team, and Michelle Englund from Saskatchewan and Carrie Galusha from the Northwest Territories, Yukon. So that's when our coverage begins next weekend. Nine to three. So Manitoba chips away. They get two in the sixth. And here in seven, it will be Alberta that has the last rock playing their red stone.
Okay. Right on top, you got it.
And
same
it's
weight.
A pleasure to welcome the reigning Canadian champion, Amber Holland, who joins us. Where are you watching this? You're not at the curling club in Crono, are you?
No, actually, I'm on my couch comfortably at home.
What do you think about this? Does it bring back some memories of playing juniors? It's, what, 20 years, isn't it?
Yeah, I know. I knew someone was going to bring up that 20-year number. Yeah, you know, it's great to sit and watch the juniors. I think it's always refreshing to see the young talent coming up. And, you know, obviously all the players that have played in the juniors and still continue to play. So, enjoying it.
Well, what do you think of this?
Well, you know, obviously...
Look at this.
Oh, this is great.
1992. And you in Saskatchewan, 7-4 over Northern Ontario to win the championship. And Merv Fonger was your coach then. And Merv is still coaching you today, 20 years later.
Yeah, wow, hey. Gotta love the hair.
Listen, we're just here to embarrass you.
And then the fact that I actually would have wore a kilt, and you probably couldn't pay me enough to get into one of those now.
This is different. For we say this every year about Team Canada and the preparation. We know that you struggled a little bit. You played limited tournament play. So what have you done to get ready?
Just basically tried to just stay connected with the ice. Last weekend we did go to Edmonton to the National Training Center and worked there for a weekend and just tried to kind of prep for, do some planning for the Scotties. And yeah, just, you know, there's not much you can do as Team Canada. You don't have that provincial play down to go play in and get ready. So our play downs start when we hit the ice in Red Deer.
Amber, you haven't had the greatest gold trail year, the money title, but I've been telling everybody that wants to listen that you're right on schedule for what you're trying to do this year.
Yeah, it's. I always have said that, you know, we always have this separate cast season and play down season, and there's been years that the cast season has gone really well for myself, and then play downs don't. So, you know, obviously we would have loved to do better in the cast field, but that's behind us now, and we're just looking forward to stepping on the ice in the Scotties.
It's obvious when you look at the... number of skips this year to be in Red Deer. The number of players who have come out of the junior ranks, why do you think that is?
I just think that the juniors are such a great stepping stone for the women. You know, there's so many great events that you can play in now as the juniors. And I think for those of us that had success at the junior age, you know, I'm watching these teams here and you get the bug, right? It's you have success early, and then you want to just keep going on. And you get to play in a Canadian final in the juniors, and then you just want to do that in the rest of your career.
Well, just look at the field for the Scotties, and these are the skips who have won championships, yourself included in 92. And then there are other players within teams that have won championships. Caitlin Laws comes to mind with Jennifer Jones. You know, Russ was saying earlier when we were chatting, it's everyone has what looks to be a terrific delivery. The players today in junior, I'm speaking of, know the game so well. They don't get caught on strategy. There seems to have been this real evolution when it comes to the game.
Yeah, the game has definitely progressed, even from the footage there from ours. You know, when we played in the national juniors, that we still didn't have the free rock rule. And now look where that game has taken us, and all of the players are working harder now than I think they ever have before, right from a young age. So you're starting to see such great talent earlier.
Speaking of great talent, that must have been a great final with Stephanie Lawton and Michelle Englot. Did you get to see that game?
Actually, no, I was on the ice practicing.
Oh, good for you.
That game was going on. We just kept on checking the line score, so I didn't get to see it. But
yep.
Yeah, it's. I know Michelle is really excited to be back at the Scotties, and I emailed her after the next day, and kind of said it doesn't get old, does it? And she said, nope, not at all.
Brittany Tran, the Alberta champions, trying to open things up. Right now, it is Manitoba sitting the one. Just edge of the button, front of the tee line. So you open against Newfoundland Labrador, Heather Strong. There's bound to be, I would think, with yourself, Michelle there, some Saskatchewan folks are going to make the trip in.
Yes, I think there's going to be a lot of folks that make the trip in. I think right now our section that our fans coordinated have almost 100 people in the Team Canada section. So I'm sure with Michelle's cheering section as well, we'll be quite strong with the Saskatchewan people coming to watch.
Amber, always a pleasure. We look forward to seeing you again. All the very best as Team Canada at the Scotties that starts next weekend in Red Deer.
Thanks for having me. I look forward to it.
Amber Holland, the reigning Canadian champion. And again, our coverage from Red Deer starts today, next Saturday.
Are we trying for the run or just the peel?
Well, you know, here we go.
Okay, run or peel?
If you want tickets, go to curling.ca. Join us in Red Deer.
Peel.
This opportunity here, you've got one in there. You've got now, with this lead, you're Alberta, you're chasing.
Yeah, you have to. It's just the way the rule is. It's a beautiful part about the four rock roll. You utilize it to your advantage. Alberta put up or Manitoba, I should say, put up a couple guards, got a couple of slight half misses, and they now have a chance here with one in a good spot. They could even come in here and angle freeze to the top red one, make it really difficult. Team talking to the skip about good extension. Just a reminder, it's a great coaching here on this team. You can tell they're still in good spirits. They're still communicating. And what they're saying about extension is if you don't extend and add a little bit of rotation with these sharp rocks, the rocks are going to make a left-hand turn in this case and over-curl. So they have to get it out to the broom and be positive. It will finish if you have the right speed. Here it comes.
Yeah, go now.
That's a lot tougher shot than it looks with that huge finish to guard that perfectly. There's no chance to get that back yellow and have to rip another guard here for Alberta.
All right, you got her, Josh.
What?
I said you got her.
A little surprised they're playing it on the outturn side, Vic. They played a lot of outturns this end, and they know the spot, but don't want to jam this. Half a rock peel might jam onto the second yellow and leave a yellow rock in the wrong spot here. You could just simply peel it with the other turn and get it out of the way. Just over curls, you can run it right onto your own.
Yep. Hard. Hard.
Jocelyn Peterman.
Ooh, might work.
Oh, and she just taps it in behind her own. It's right on the pin. Now Manitoba will have a chance to cover it.
Again, the danger of peeling it that way, that can't happen if you peel it with the intern, but slightly a bad break all the same, and a great chance to steal one.
Did I throw that last one good?
Yeah.
Okay. We're still one, right? Okay, just a two, yeah. That was horrible.
Yeah. That hurt. Okay, you got it.
20? 15.
Yeah,
we
that
just
one
wanted
came
two,
down a bit.
Okay.
You could throw 20, yeah.
20?
Yeah.
Okay, 20. Okay. Don't jump it.
Yeah.
A little over 5.5 feet of ice given for this guard.
Well, a little wide.
Yep.
Yeah. Four, five.
A little deeper out of the hand. This looks deep. Cannot be in the rings.
Right now, Manitoba sitting one. Boy, it's got a really hook for them.
The line's going to be fine, Vic. They just don't want it too deep.
Well, why aren't we cornering it?
It's not there. It's not there.
It's top 12.
Oh. Okay.
Too deep.
It was really sliding for a bit.
A little bit, Vic. It's not as bad as I expected out of her hand. It looked like it was coming right to the forefoot and when she let it go, but slowed down at the end, and now a decision to make for Alberta.
95.
Oh my gosh. Yeah. Sorry.
That's fine. Just gotta get
our one here.
Hey, you know, think of this.
What are you playing at? A 10? 9.5? Okay.
If you are Alberta and you're Jocelyn Peterman, you just gave up a deuce and you're still leading 9-3. But what if you give up a steal here?
Yeah, exactly.
Just a single.
That's exactly what happens. And it's a Canadian championship. You're sitting there going, I've got my trophy on, you know, my name's half printed on the trophy already. And it changes your mindset. Just stay in the moment here, one shot at a time.
Peterman now trying to run it back. Conchu, Anderson picking her up. You can hear Brittany Tran hold it for her, run it back, and move it far enough. Yes, they do. For a single point. Alberta will get one more here in 7. February 27th, it's the NHL trade deadline, and TSN will have you covered with all-day coverage beginning at 8 a.m. Eastern Time. Every trade, every deal, everywhere you are. Trade Center 2012 on TSN and TSN Mobile TV. So Alberta picks up the single in 7. Maybe settle some nerves despite their big lead. And here in the 8th, it'll be Manitoba with the last drop. They have the hammer playing the Yellow Stars. Mariah Mondor.
Manitoba fans have just been great. You know, they're so far down and they're just cheering in every shot. You saw the smile out of Mariah there, and it's nice to see. It's not all about winning and losing, and there's a lot of great memories in these events. And if Manitoba can't come back and win this game, it's still been a phenomenal week, a great year.
Okay, good sweet shot.
What?
No, just
I don't mind on top.
Yeah,
same weight, Chris.
You got her.
Yeah, I do. Bit of discussion here, you know, with a big lead like this, do you really need another red one in play for Alberta?
Closest aim, 7-6.
Probably no good spot to put this rock. You could zip this right through and make it a little less complicated later in the end.
You got room. Take a look.
No bomb.
5.
Gotta go.
Do it.
Oh.
Nice shot, Chris.
Oh. Beauty.
Good seat, girl.
Great shot.
Nice weight. What a throw.
Two perfect throws by Christine there. You stagger those or you come up light or even heavy for that matter. It would be very detrimental for Alberta. Just in a great spot. Manitoba goes around those. It's a simple raise.
Earned his place in the field. Fifth qualifier for the Tim Hortons Brian Saskatoon. Earlier this evening in Bridgewater, Nova Scotia, Mark Dacey, a former Nova Scotia champion, Canadian champion.
Really hard. Go hard.
In an extra end was a 7-6 winner over Kent Smith.
That's not bad.
And so Mark Dacey will now play Jamie Murphy in the Nova Scotia final tomorrow in Bridgewater. And, of course, should Dacey win that, he would go to the national championship, as is his wife, Heather Smith Dacey. She will be in Red Deer representing Nova Scotia.
Be shutting down the Tim Hortons and to let them both go. And Mark would love to get there. He's from Saskatchewan, the Briar being there, and it would give him a little more incentive. But Jamie Murphy's got a great young team. I've played him quite a few times, and they've been knocking on the door for a long time, get close to the provincials every year.
So we'll update you on the Nova Scotia final tomorrow, and we join you with the Men's Canadian Junior Championship tomorrow evening, 7 p.m. Eastern Time. Good scrub. Good scrub. Cates and Montour. And they get a little separation and now an angle on that stone. But it's behind the longer center line guard.
That went hard there.
Yeah. Miss Peel on the Alberta team. Whoa, and they, whoa, it gives a little bit of life to Manitoba here. This one's wide. I think it's flashed the top one. What's it going to do at the back?
Okay. Misses that, well, one.
I got that one.
Misses
out of the
those
way.
Two.
What?
Got that one out of the way. This is back to your point, Vic. It, sometimes you put it in cruise control.
I know, exactly.
No one even laughs at me.
7 points is a lot, but you have to keep executing. That's 2 mistakes in a row.
That was my biggest fear.
Okay. Was my rotation lazy?
No, it was good. It was good.
It really went. Was it? I was up?
Yeah, I think 70. I think it's coming down.
What
yeah,
was that so that I just threw?
60.
I had a 60.
We didn't extend.
Whoa!
Whoa, I took it out.
Just go for the back.
Whoa.
One.
Yep. Yep.
Whoa.
Yes! Hard, hard.
To get it by the yellow. Don't want to tick the yellow. It might roll right through the rings.
Well, just a little bit of a rub. And it will hang around.
Great call by the skipper. Just swept it enough early. It did tick the yellow, but thin enough to still hit enough of the red to slow that thrown rock down. Just you can just see it graze the yellow, but thin enough to save it.
Stick the one we're raising, right? All right, you got it.
That's all you need to hear. We want to stick the one we're raising. A lot of weight being thrown here with such a big deficit. You hit this in the wrong spot, you can kill both your rocks. So this has to be made perfectly. But they're going to throw a normal at 10, hit it a little off center, try to stick the yellow raised rock in behind the corner guard, and roll over to the far side, keep some separation.
Whoa.
Shannon Burchard. Run it back. And out the back.
We talked about this earlier, you know, in the good sliding surface here. You're really fighting that hog line. See that just the old hot potato. Get that hand off before you're called on the hog line. It's tough to be accurate when you have to do that.
But earlier, her release was actually off the top. She was yanking it back. This one was more of straight back.
Nope. Okay,
that's good.
And the shooter will roll out of play.
That's all right. Nice, sir.
Nice situation here now. Get one around the corner. Keep it high in front of the tee line. Unfortunately for Manitoba, the other two rocks are wide open. But there's a chance to jam at the back. Get this one buried at least. They go for an open one, roll out. You go around to the center guard again, have two buried. Chance for a potential three.
Wait, it's pretty good.
Roll over.
Roll
over.
Roll
over.
Four. Five.
Four.
Great line here.
Five.
Should
nine,
finish.
Yes.
Six.
Now Mondor and McCush.
Six.
We're deeper.
To the top eight behind the corner.
You just a little.
Now in the perfect world here, Jocelyn would like to come down, hit this and roll over a little bit into this area and maybe actually sit buried, but to hit it on that angle, she has to be very careful of this jam at the back here. If she jams at the back, there's a chance to sit four for Manitoba. So you have to be careful here. You'd love to roll buried, but Not at the expense of jamming.
Jocelyn Peterman.
Nice shot. Gotta go.
And it'll spill out into the open on the wide side. It is the shot rock.
Just be honored here. Nice throw.
So, let's take a look at some player numbers.
Well, Jocelyn Peterman, like I said, from about the 6th, 7th end on this afternoon's game, has been flawless, 89%. Great run back last end, and she's really applied the pressure. And that's exactly what happens in curling. Selena's had some tough shots. 67% is not what you'd want, but the degree of difficulty in her shots has been the difference.
The player comparisons are brought to you by Capital One. What's in your wallet?
Great chance here, Vic. A little soft weight here, a little bit more than hack weight. Roll to the inside. There's lots of room around that long guard. Sink another one, and then it's decision time for Alberta.
Manitoba does have the hammer here in the eighth. Oh, and now it will roll over and roll out into the open.
That's too bad. That would have been a great opportunity to get on that a little sooner. That really curled hard. She threw that with lots of speed.
Sorry.
See what they say.
Shoot.
Don't worry about it. You got her.
Can I wait good?
Yeah. We're going to have a double here.
Maybe
a tad more.
Yeah.
9.5.
One thing I've been impressed by so far is the brushing of both teams.
Mm-hmm.
They've saved some stones.
Strong brushing. Good judgment. The teams are so much better coached nowadays. It's just amazing to watch.
10.
A little hit and stay here. There might be a double opportunity for three.
Whoa.
And that's Shannon Burchard picked up right away.
Oh, boy.
Yeah. Piece. She's going to roll out.
Oh, yeah, that's fine.
Oh, she will. And so Manitoba will have a chance for three.
That's fine.
That's just great to see. The Manitoba hung in there. The odds of coming back here are slim, but to hang in there, have the attitude to never give up, and they're a great chance for three here.
Makes it just... Don't want to count them before they're on the board, but you know, you get three here. It's a four-point game, two ends.
Maybe a touch-up.
Get to throw two guards, the free guard zone.
You got it. Yeah.
Alberta will have to work for it.
You won't have the hammer, of course, but. Here they go, two. McCorsh, Mondor have saved several stones so far. Can they do it again? Yes, they can. Manitoba will get three here in eight. Coach Lance Wedelius, the Bison are happy. It's time now for the M&M Meat Shop's Final End Challenge. Right after the game, we want you to go to www.finalend.ca and enter the secret word for a chance to win a trip for two to see the 2013 World Junior Championship in Sochi, Russia, the home of the 2014 Olympic Winter Games. The first 100 entries will have a chance to win a $50 M&M gift card, and all participants will get an M&M discount. We will give you the secret word shortly. M&M Meat Shop's Final End Challenge. Welcome back to Napanee, Ontario, the Strathcona Paper Center. So Manitoba, you know, half this half of the game, 6-7-8. Manitoba's outscored Alberta 5-1. They're down by four, but the all-important last rock here in nine belongs to Alberta, playing the Red Stones. Manitoba lead is Mariah Mondor.
Nicely done. 5 points with Hammer in the last three ends for Manitoba. And it's, you know, it's not over yet. There's still time. Two guards here. Steal at least a point. Game on in 10.
Gonna slide. Gonna slide. Yeah, Selena.
You'd love to line these up. That's the key. You
mean,
they got to brush this to get it over. Otherwise, there's going to be a double later in the end. See the stagger with the two yellows. There's a natural double there to remove both and roll the red Alberta stone out of play. You'd like to get those lines straight up.
Line's pretty good.
I think
7, 6, 6, 7, 8.
Room.
8.
7, it's coming down.
8.
7. 7. 7. 7, 6. Wait, it's nice.
Great communication. They're always predicting where that's going to stop. 7, 6, 7, 8. Figure it's going to be a foot short of the tee line. That's exactly where it is.
Hey, let's update you on some other provincial playdowns in Manitoba. The top four teams going in to the Manitoba Championship are still alive. Here's the scenario right now as they're still on the ice. And Mike McEwen, who is dominated the tour this year, has a 5-4 lead over Bill Libren of Deer Lodge. They're playing in the seventh. 5-4 McEwen. The winner will go on to Sunday's final. The loser will drop into the semifinal against the winner of Rob Fowler and Jeff Stoughton, the reigning Canadian and world champion. And they are currently tied 4-4 playing seven. The loser there is out.
Goes home, and Stoughton's had a couple of his backs up against the wall virtually for 2 days now, and he's hanging in there. A big three-ender this morning to stay alive, and never count Mr. Stoughton out.
Well, he was in a situation where he had to win five in a row to retain the championship.
And here's the situation we talked about, the staggered yellows, a chance to get them both.
Rebecca Konshu.
That's fine, Beck. Nice shot.
And she'll get the top.
Nice shots, Chris.
Thanks. Christine Anderson's played a great game here for Alberta. You you tend to look at the four-ender and the five-ender and the shots that the skip made to do that. But some great position rocks. When you're ahead, getting those first two rocks in the right spot makes all the difference in an end.
Gave it a bit at the end.
Quickly, Brittany Tran and Christine Anderson. Going to get them both. One. And across the top.
Just over brushed it a shade. The keys get rid of something, though, and rolling the shooter out of the way, but that was close to getting them all.
Back eight. Back four.
Good sweep.
Here, just good?
Just to her, hey?
Might be in a bit of a hurry to get into the rings here. You know what the opponent's going to do with a four-point lead and Hammer this late in the game. They're going to peel anything, so you could delay this. But by going in the rings this early, it allows Alberta more opportunities, four opportunities to actually remove both yellows here.
Oh, never mind. Give me just a little less. Okay.
I think 70.
When you're deciding on your shot selection, always take into consideration what the other team's up to. And you know Alberta's eliminating anything out in front if they get the chance.
Weight's good. Eight.
Nine.
No.
Climb.
Slow
down.
Whoa. Close.
Curl.
That's fine.
it's time now to give you the secret word for our M&M Meat Chops Final End Challenge. And the secret word is finish. So right after the game, go to www.finalend.ca. Put the word in for a chance to win a trip for two to the 2013 World Junior Curling Championship in Sochi, Russia. The winner of this event, both men and women, will go to the World Junior Championships to be played this year, March 3 through 11, in Östersund, Sweden.
Therein lies the problem with Manitoba going in so early. It set up a double, and no mistake from the Alberta team. They played a lot of shots this game. Nicely done. Cleans everything out of there. One lone guard. That's all Manitoba has to use here for the steal. Feet heavy, a little bit lighter. That would have crossed right over to the face of the red one. Made this a lot more difficult shot.
Good first one. Really
now, do you hit the second shot, or do you get rid of that guard? Because the only one that's going to hurt you at this point in time is the guard.
What do you think?
I don't mind either.
What?
I don't mind either.
Could phone a friend here.
If we hit, she's just we're giving her like a, something more to freeze on, are we not?
Not if we're top four, though.
No, if we hit. Though.
Oh, yeah.
I think we gotta play that toss.
Yeah, I like it.
We roll away though if we hit.
Or we peel, but then they just hit, right?
No, they'd freeze.
Okay. You better.
At the last second, they mentioned the peel as an option, and then that would allow Manitoba to sit too, but that's really not a problem. The front would be open,
mine's
and a well-executed shot for Jocelyn. You score, and that's all you need to do here. That the guard is the problem rocker.
Gotta go. Five.
Mine's good. Go
five,
hard.
Four,
go hard.
Gotta
really hard, girls. Push hard.
Be in.
Push hard. Go.
Looks good.
Hard.
Get it five.
Hard.
Get it
really hard, Chris. Go. 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 Hard.
Hard. Hard. Get it five. Get it five. You got it. Go. Go. Go.
Keep going. Keep going. Keep going.
Okay. Nice weight. How's it go? Nice throw.
Good sweep, girls.
Oh, I'm sorry.
It's coming down.
I got a 409 on that one.
Yeah, it's coming down.
Just a hit. Not too much.
It's time now for the game story.
Well, it's been all Alberta right from the middle of the fourth end there. They made some good strategy calls, a great hit and roll set it up, and they really went after it in the fifth. A lot of teams would be defensive with after scoring the four, and they didn't. They went, stayed aggressive, and it paid off, and just a well-played end.
The game story brought to you by M&M Meat Chops. Hundreds of meal ideas, one aisle.
I thought she did.
Okay,
95-4?
Yeah,
you can
four.
Throw four,
yeah.
We drank four.
Okay. Don't
jump. If you're a young skip and you're really working on your strategy, that's play this end backwards, because what you have to do for Manitoba, you have to steal here to stay in this game. The only way you're going to steal is force Alberta to a tough shot. This is to be a tough shot for Alberta if this shot's made because of the shot they just played. They had to peel that guard, open it up. Yes, Manitoba would sit too, but your shot would be very, very easy. If this is made, tough for Alberta.
Selena Cates trying to wrap it around.
Roll it a little, Kristen. Yep, yep, yep.
What is that?
One in there?
Yeah.
A 91.
You made it good?
Yeah. 95 or?
That's a shame. They get that by with beautiful speed control, and it's been the story of the game for a lot of the teams, Vic.
It's
such aggressive rocks, so much curl. They just can't seem to get the broom in the right spot. They just need another 3 or 4 inches of ice there, and that was gold.
You got her.
Now with two guards out in front, and it kind of changes Alberta's options. If there's only the one, you'd peel it all day. Now they're going to go around, try to get to the top of the button here, and choke off any opportunity for Manitoba to steal.
Wait, looks pretty good.
For line, for line, yep.
Line only.
Yep, 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 yep,
Anderson and Conchu. Through the hole, past the top guard. And then they'll rub off their own, spill in. Alberta is sitting one back of the button.
Nice roll.
Yeah, it's just tight right away.
Yeah.
You have to move it a little, that's okay.
Yeah.
But
okay.
Just it's there.
Okay.
Yeah.
That last shot by Jocelyn didn't quite end up where they wanted it. They wanted to get it there, but in hindsight, it's probably a better spot because if this yellow one from Manitoba comes into this area, there will be an opportunity to get out of jail with that last rock that was thrown. So always be cognizant of that if you're vicing or skipping whoever's holding the broom in charge of the house. There are other options, and by ticking off and rolling wide open with this red rock, it's in a good position for the last shot for Alberta.
You got it.
95?
Yep.
Maybe last gasp here for Manitoba and the team from the St. Vitale in Winnipeg. Selena Cates.
Got a lot of weight.
Nine's not the number you want to hear. It can't be more than six to make a curl. This will never finish if it's a nine.
Funny noise.
Tapping
hours.
Oh, wait.
What was
that?
I had an 81.
I should grit away, I guess, right?
Yeah. All right. Okay.
You like that?
Yeah, so for now.
I might either. Is it just going under?
Hit it like half. I'll throw pretty hard. Do you like this?
Might as well. We're guaranteed one here, right?
What?
We're guaranteed one here.
Yeah.
So.
I don't mind it here. Yeah.
Smart call here. This obviously could end the game right here. It's a thin, thick double. You have to throw it really hard, but it will go off the back here. You score at least three or four, possibly five. Low risk shot too. There's nothing can go wrong. You've already got your point. This will be humming.
Wait, it's good.
Yeah.
For the championship.
Yep.
Jocelyn Peterman. Alberta. Anderson. Conchu. Got one. Move
That's
it over.
Right. Nice
Move it far enough, and she'll get two more, maybe three.
Two.
Alberta. And Jocelyn Peterman out of the red here, curling club. Will win the M&M Meat Shops Women's Canadian Junior Championship. Along with Coach Nancy McKinnery. And to the delight of family and friends. They've waited a long time for this. And now they can celebrate a Canadian championship. And they will wear the maple leaf at the World Junior Curling Championships in Östersund, Sweden. Make the final. Alberta, 12. Manitoba, 6. Score four in the fourth, five, a steal in five, and it is a win for Alberta and Jocelyn Peterman and her team from Red Deer. And it's congratulations to Jocelyn. As mentioned, it's been a long time coming. Last year was a difficult year for you. You lose the final of the provincial, you lose the final of the Canada Winter Games, but you stay with it. And your coach said that this was a team that never gave up. You win it, the provincial this year, and now you're here, a Canadian champion. Congratulations.
Thank you. Yeah, everyone said, you know, we learned from those losses, and that sucked at the time, and we didn't want to hear it. But we really did learn a lot on how to play the games and, like, the finals and being mentally prepared for it.
Well, and also, you know, you think about round robin this week. You were brought down 6-0 at one point in time to Newfoundland and Labrador, and then you came back to win it in an extra.
Yeah.
Says a lot about your team.
Yeah, we've played a lot of games like that where we just need to stay in there the whole game. So, yeah.
Well, now, as Canadian champion, you get to wear the maple leaf, and off to Sweden you go.
Yeah, we've been working for this all year, so it feels good.
Well, now you have to practice your Swedish.
Yes, yes, for sure.
Congratulations to you and the entire team, and it was a pleasure to watch you.
Thank you.
Alberta is the women's junior Canadian champion. We'll have the presentation of medals when we come back.
The M&M Meat Shop's Canadian Juniors is brought to you by M&M Meat Shop's. Hundreds of meal ideas, one aisle.
And here they are, the M&M Meat Shop's Canadian Women Junior Champions for 2012, coached by Nancy McKinnery. Their lead, Christine Anderson. Second, Rebecca Conchu. Throwing the third stone, Brittany Tran. And skip Jocelyn Peterman out of the Red Deer Curling Club. And as they said, and as she said to me, Russ, they've waited a long time. And last year, losing isn't fun. But they stayed with it. This team that has been together for 3 years is now the Canadian champion.
Well, you get to a bunch of finals, especially out of a tough province like Alberta or Manitoba. You're playing a great team. You're not going to win every time. And they've learned from those losses, and they've turned it around to a positive. And the full marks today, they were amazing.
It's time now for our medal presentation.
It is my pleasure to invite Mr. John Wisson, Vice President Franchising and Development, M&M Meat Shops, to come forward with congratulations on behalf of the title sponsor, M&M Meat Shops.
Thank you. On behalf of M&M Meat Shops, Les Aliments M&M, and our franchisees at 456 stores across Canada, I wish to congratulate the host chair, Stephen Paul, the host committee, the town of Greater Napanee, and all of the volunteers for putting on such a great event this week. This is the seventh year that M&M Meat Shops has sponsored the Canadian Junior Curling Championships, and we are proud to support Canadian youth in their quest for gold here and at the World Championships in Östersund, Sweden. Congratulations to all the competitors who put on such a great show throughout the week. And congratulations to the new Canadian Junior Women's Champions from Alberta. Good luck and good curling at the Worlds. Thank you.
Mr. Wisson will present bronze medals to the bronze medal team from British Columbia, while Jim Campbell, Vice Chair of the Canadian Curling Association Board of Governors, presents Keeper Awards. Coach Jim Newlands.
They lost the semifinal earlier today out of the Nanaimo
Lead
Curling
Brooklyn
Club.
Leach.
It's the Van Osch family.
Second, Marika Van Osch.
Marika is 15. She will turn 16
Third,
on Monday.
That's right, Kalia Van Osch.
Her sister Kalia is 18. And the skip is 20-year-old Kesa.
Kesa Van
Osch. So this is their final year together. They have been playing together ever since Marika was 9 years of age.
Mr. Wisson will now present silver medals to the silver medal team from Manitoba.
It's a tough break for them in the semifinal game. In fact, they just fractured on a guard coming around. They had Alberta in a pile of trouble and fractured on a guard, rolled in the rings, set up a double. Jocelyn made no mistake and scored the four, but I think if BC doesn't throw the rock, the best Alberta's going to get is one. So that was the big turning point in the semifinal.
Manitoba team out of the St. Vital Curling Club in Winnipeg.
Second, Kristen McCush.
Thank you.
Third, Selena Cates. And skip, Shannon Burchard.
Difficult. It's one thing to give up the four, but that steal
Mr.
of
Wilson
five
will now
for all intents and purposes
to the ended it.
Yeah, it was lights out at that point in time. No question about
Jim
it.
Jim Campbell presents keeper awards.
Kind of snuck up on them a little bit too, Vic. You know, it was just a matter of, you know, a couple run backs hitting it in the wrong side, leaving some staggered guards. And
Coach
full
Nancy
marks from Alberta,
Mackiner,
though, for playing the end so well as they did.
Lead, Christine Anderson.
Thank you. Thank you.
Second,
thank you.
Rebecca Conchu.
And you go back to Rebecca's shot that you highlighted as a key shot of the game, that
third,
come around.
Brittany Tran.
Yeah, hit and rolled an undercover, and they it forced
Jocelyn Peterman.
Manitoba's hand, and that made all the difference.
Thank you.
Mr. Wisson of M&M Meat Shops will now present the M&M Championship Trophy to the 2012 Junior Women's Winners from the province of Alberta.
Congratulations to Alberta out of the Red Deer Curling Club. They'll now wear the maple leaf in Östersund, Sweden.
The M&M Meat Shops Canadian Juniors is brought to you by World Financial Group. Proud to be a sponsor of the Season of Champions. Your dreams, our strategies. By Ford, official automotive partner of the Canadian Curling Association. And by Tim Hortons new lattes, made with premium espresso.
A reminder, we'll be with you Sunday evening, 7 p.m. Eastern Time, for the men's final of the Canadian Juniors. Out of the Saville Sports Centre in Edmonton, Brendan Butcher, he's already there, and he will play either Northern Ontario's Brendan Work of Thunder Bay or Manitoba's Kyle Deering of Winnipeg. They'll play their semifinal tomorrow afternoon. The winner on to Alberta at 7 p.m. Eastern Time. Our congratulations again to Jocelyn Peterman of Alberta. She is the M&M Meat Shops Canadian Junior Women's Champion. So now on behalf of Russ and our entire crew, thank you for joining us. The best in Canadian curling is here on Canada Sports Leader, TSN.